In today's world, with increasing cross-cultural interaction and collaboration, intercultural competence is crucial for understanding one another. In this video, we will be taking a trip through the brain in order to see what happens during intercultural learning. There are around 86 billion neurons in the brain in a constant communicative state with one another. Neurons release chemical messengers called neurotransmitters, which cause an electrical signal to travel from one cell to another and make a connection in order to form a greater network. This ability of the brain to change and reorganize itself into new networks is known as neuroplasticity. It allows us to learn new information and adapt to new cultural environments. Through the cellular network, new information is stored temporarily as short-term memory. The brain is designed to perceive and generate patterns because they give context to information that would otherwise be dismissed as meaningless. So, by linking something new to patterns of related information already found in the existing memory, we are able to later store it as a long-term memory and recall it after months or even years. Pattern recognition allows us to learn cultural elements such as languages, traditions, values, and behavior in general. Let's think of our brain as a big forest with many trees representing the neurons. Making a connection between two cells is like making a trail from one tree to another. The more we walk this trail, the more apparent it will be. And the moment we stop walking it, weeds and trees will start growing and the trail will be lost. The same thing happens with the connections between neurons. If there is no electrical signal traveling through the cells, the connection will be lost. This is known as the use it or lose it principle. The development of stable neural networks generally relies on repeated experience and behavior, and this process can take quite some time. Something to remember when adapting in an intercultural environment. The brain is programmed to pay special attention to any experience that is new or unusual. This attraction to novelty is what motivates us to explore and learn about new environments. However, when engaged in tasks that do not agree with our cultural values, we require increased attention, because the new information contradicts that already stored in the memory. The brain needs extra focus and energy to explain the difference. If the new information is useful, it becomes memory that can be retrieved later. But if it's not useful or we don't trust the source, the brain will forget it altogether, preferring to stick to what we already know. Because less attention processing is required for new information that agrees with our own cultural values, prior knowledge is personal, complex, and therefore highly resistant to change. So, being with people from a similar culture is a choice that reduces effort for the brain, but a new intercultural encounter establishes new neural pathways. Every time we learn something new and form a new memory, there are so many physical changes happening between neurons that it's safe to say we wake up with a new brain every single day.